हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज एट्थ वीडियो ऑन सीक्वेंस एंड इनफाइनाइट सीरीज। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय टेलीस्कोपिंग सीरीज एंड सम थ्योरम्स रिलेटेड टू द कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ सीरीज। नाउ व्हाट इज द टेलीस्कोपिक सीरीज? Let's suppose you are given a series of the form 1 over n into n plus 1, where n is varying from 1 to infinity. We have to check the behavior of this series. So till now we have done what is the GP series and what is the GP series test, then nth term divergent test, right? Now just see, is it a GP series? No, it is not of the form GP series, which is summation a into rn minus 1. So we cannot apply this GP series test. The next is nth term divergent test. So what is the nth term over here? It is 1 over n into n plus 1. When you find out the limit of this, this will go to 0 as n goes to infinity. So nth term divergent test is also not applicable over here, because whenever the limit of nth term is zero, we can't say the behavior of the series. So we have to apply some another test, right? The next is a sequence of partial sums. Now just see, what is your Sn? Your Sn is 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus and so on 1 over n into n plus 1. Okay, so here we can write this Sn as, now just see, we can write this Sn as 1 upon 2 can be written as 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 into 2 into 1 by 3 can be written as 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 and so on 1 over n minus 1 over n plus 1. So we can write the terms as, which are given to 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2 into 3 and so on plus 1 into n plus 1. By making the partial fractions, we can write this as this. So we can write 1 by 2 as 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 by 6 as 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, 1 by n into n plus 1 as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. And now just see, these terms are cancel out, inside terms are cancel out, and you left with the first term and the last term. So such type of series is said to be telescopic. So whenever you find out the sum of first n terms, you will see the terms will be cancel out, you left with the first and the last term, right? And then you find out the limit of it. When you find out the limit of Sn, now in this case it comes out to 1 because this term going to 0. So this implies that your series 1 over n into n plus 1, this is convergent. Now why this is convergent? Because the sequence of partial sum, that is convergent and that is going to 1 as n goes to infinity. So therefore the series 1 over n into n plus 1 is convergent, and the sum of this series is, sum of this series is 1, right? So if we have a question like find out the sum of the following series, then either we can find the sum with the help of GP series test. A series of this form is convergent if mod of R is strictly less than 1 and it converges to A upon 1 minus R, or by using the telescoping series by finding the nth sequence of nth partial sums, and we will see the terms cancel out, we left with the first and the last. So that's why this is called telescoping series. And when you find out the limit of it, if it is finite, you will say your series is convergent, and the sum of the series is the value of the limit to which this sequence of nth partial sums convergent, right? So this one becomes the sum of the series, this. So in this way we can apply this telescoping series test and we can find out the sum of the series if it is convergent, right? You can See one more example related to the telescoping series. Now just see, for example, if you find have to find out the sum of the series, one more example related to telescoping series. Now just see, let's suppose you have to find out the sum of the series 1 over ln n plus 2 minus 1 over ln n plus 1, where your n is varying from 1 to infinity. So we can find out the sum of this series by finding the sequence of nth partial sum. So it will be what? When you put n to be 1, this is ln 3 minus 1 over ln 2 plus 1 over ln 4 minus 1 over ln 2. When you put n to be 2, you will have this is 4 and this is 3. Plus 1 over ln 5 minus 1 over ln 4. And so on, the last term 1 over ln n plus 2 minus 1 over ln n plus 1. So this is the sum of first n terms, and you will see the terms are cancelled out. This 1 over ln 3 will be cancelled out with this. This will be cancelled out with this, and so on. You left with the term this and this. So what is your SN? Your SN is 1 over ln n plus 2 minus 1 over ln 2. So when you find out the limit of this SN, if this value is finite, you will say your series is convergent, otherwise not. So 1 over infinity, this gives you 0, minus 1 over ln 2. So this series is convergent because this number is finite. So this implies that the given series 1 over ln n plus 2 minus 1 over ln n plus 1, this series is convergent. And the sum of the series is, and the sum is minus 1 over ln 2. So in this way, we can apply the telescoping series test. Now just see more results related to the convergence, to the convergence of the series. And that's, this theorem says that let's suppose you are given two series, both are convergent, and let's suppose this series is convergent and its sum is capital A. Similarly, the series BN is convergent and its sum is capital B. Then the sum rule says that the series AN plus BN, both, whenever both series are convergent, their sum is also convergent. Moreover, it converges to A plus B, means the sum of this series will be A plus B. Similarly, the difference rule, if two series are convergent, then their difference is also convergent. Moreover, they are converging to A minus B, right, which is the difference of the limits of the series A, AN as well as BN. The third is the constant multiple rule. Means, if you are having any constant, and if the given series AN is convergent, then K times AN is also convergent and it converges to K times the limit of the series AN. Right? So these are the rules. Whenever you have two convergent series, their sum is also convergent. Moreover, the sum of the series will be the sum of the first series plus sum of the second series. Right? So that will be A plus B. Similarly, the difference of two convergent series is again convergent. Similarly, any constant multiple of convergent series is also convergent and converging to K times the sum of the series AN. You can see this result that every नॉन जीरो कॉन्स्टेंट मल्टीपल ऑफ डाइवर्जेंट सीरीज इज ऑलवेज डाइवर्जेंट. Now, what does it mean? Means, let's suppose this AN series is divergent, and if you consider K to be any non-zero constant, then the constant multiple of AN is also divergent, right? Similarly, if the series AN is convergent and the series BN, this is divergent, then the sum means AN plus BN and the difference means AN minus BN, both these series are divergent. Now means what? Whenever you are having one series as convergent series and other as divergent, then the sum and the difference, both they are divergent, right? So whenever series AN is divergent, any non-zero constant multiple is also divergent. And similarly, if one is convergent, other is divergent, then their sum and difference both are divergent. And now just see examples related to these theorems. Let's suppose you have to find the sum of the following series if it is convergent. So the given series is 3 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 upon 6 to the power n minus 1, where n is varying from 1 to infinity. Now just see, we can write this as 1 over 6 to the power n minus 1, and this 3n will be cancelled out and you left with 1 over 2 minus 1 over 6 to the power n minus 1. Further, you can write this as 1 over 2 to the power n minus 1 minus series 1 over 6 to the power n minus 1. Both these are the GP series with first series mein the common ratio is half, which is strictly less than 1, and this is also a GP series with common ratio which is 1 by 6 less than 1. So by GP series test, both these series are convergent. Right, so therefore by difference rule, the series 3 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 upon 6 to the power n minus 1, where n is varying from 1 to infinity, is also convergent. Now the next question is, you have to find the sum of this series. Now since it is GP series with common ratio half and the first term 1, so it converges to, what is the sum of this series? Sum of the series 1 over 2 to the power n minus 1, it will be A upon 1 minus R. So that is 2. Similarly, the sum of the series 1 over 6 to the power n minus 1 will be A upon 1 minus R. So that will be 6 upon 5. So what is the sum of this series? So the sum of the series 3 to the power n minus 1 upon 6 to the power n minus 1 minus 1, it will be the difference of these two. So that is 4 by 5. So this is the sum of the series this. So here we have applied the GP series test as well as the difference rule. Whenever both the series are convergent, the difference rule says that their difference is also convergent and they are converging to the difference of their sums, right? Similarly, check the behavior of the series 4 upon 2 to the power n minus 1, where n is varying from 1 to infinity. So we can take this 4 to outside and we can check the behavior of the series 1 over 2 to the power n minus 1. This is GP series with first term as 1 and the common ratio as half, since it is less than 1. So therefore, by GP series test, this is convergent, right? And this implies that the given series 4 upon 2 to the power n minus 1, by the constant multiple rule, it should be convergent to 4 into a upon 1 minus r. So that will be 8, right? So this is the sum of this series. So this is by constant multiple rule. So in this way, we can apply these theorems and we can check the behavior of the series, right? Now the next is adding or deleting the terms. So now just see, if you are given any series, let's suppose an is a series, so a1 plus a2 plus a3 until up to an and so on. Let's suppose this is a series. Now after adding some finite terms, the behavior of the series will not change, and after deleting some finite terms, the behavior of the series will not change. Now what does it mean? Means if your series is convergent, if this is convergent, and if we add few terms, few finite terms in the series an, if this series is convergent, after adding some finite terms, the whole series is again convergent. However, some will be changed, right? The series behavior remains the same. If this is convergent, after adding some finite terms, again it is convergent, but now the limit is changed. If this limit is L, then this limit will become L plus B1 plus B2 plus B3, right? So this will become the sum of this above series. So after adding some finite number of terms, the behavior will not change. If this series is convergent, after adding some finite terms, it remains convergent. Similarly, if you delete some terms, let's suppose we delete a1, a2, a3, so we will start the series from a4 basically. If it is convergent, then again it remains convergent, and the sum will be L minus a1 minus a2 minus a3, right? So the behavior remains the same. The same way, if you have divergent series, if you add some finite terms or delete some finite terms, if your series is divergent, it remains divergent. So after adding or deleting some finite number of terms, the behavior of the series remains the same.